Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new, my name is Bobby. Guys, it is time for the 30-day carnivore experiment review. Yes, it has been quite some time since I updated you guys on the current status. The 30-day experiment is in the past now. It has been round about 2 months since it ended. So therefore, it is time to tell you about the benefits, the downsides, and the aftermath. All right, benefit number one, digestion, right off the bat. The improvement in digestion is beyond words. As a vegan, I've been struggling with digestion for years. I suffered of diarrhea for 8 months straight. Belly pain, belly cramps, diarrhea, bloating, all of it. Once I reintroduced the animal foods, my digestion improved tremendously, but nothing in comparison to the carnivore diet. Once I eliminated all the carbohydrates, my digestion was smooth, absolutely perfect. Belly flat, no bloating, no cramping, firm stool, and most importantly, I went to the toilet once per day. When you're eating animal foods, but you still have carbohydrates in your diet, you can go to the toilet up to 2 or even 3 times, depending on the caloric intake. On the carnivore diet, however, I had to go to the toilet once per day max. Benefit number two, mental clarity. Absolutely insane. No blood sugar spikes, no blood sugar fluctuations, just this pure state of consciousness. Mental clarity all the way through. Without exaggerating here, I would describe it similar to flow state, similar to microdosing psilocybin. This state of consciousness I could only achieve with psychedelic drugs. The ketogenic state that was induced through the carnivore diet, which was zero carb, was unparalleled. Which brings me to benefit number three. Mood. Through the mental clarity, my mood improved tremendously. I had an emotional stability that I didn't experience beforehand. Groundedness. I wouldn't experience mood swings. No anger issues, no crankiness, no hangriness, no depression. Just an overwhelming feeling of bliss. Benefit number four, sleep. Yes, for the first time in years, I could sleep through. Absolutely amazing benefit. Over were the nights where I would get up to take a piss. As a vegan, I would get up 3, 4, sometimes 5 times just to take a piss. No, I wasn't drinking less. That was not the difference. Somehow my body retained the fluids. I felt hydrated and I could sleep through. I felt like I was in a coma almost. Really deep sleep. So much better regeneration. Benefit number five, satiation and enjoyment of the meals. As a vegan, especially in the later months, I would find myself frustrated. My body would reject the foods. I would find myself in vegan restaurants just looking at the menu and hating my life. No joke. I would look at quinoa, burgers, salad wraps, tempeh and tofu scrambles, and I would simply hate it. My body was naturally opposed to those foods. I couldn't find any satiation or joy in those meals. With the carnivore diet, it was quite the opposite. After every meal, I would feel satiated. As I said, no hangriness, no blood sugar roller coaster, satisfied through fat adaptation. Absolutely amazing. And what was really surprising to me is that I wouldn't feel bored by those meals. In the beginning, I thought this will be boring. No carbohydrates, no quinoa, no pasta, no rice, no sweet potatoes. It was the opposite. I didn't miss carbohydrates at all. Benefit number 6. This is a crucial one. This was really important and life-changing for me. Teeth health. My teeth health improved beyond belief. I know all of this sounds miraculous, but it is the truth. My teeth, as a vegan, not as a fruitarian, were terrible. Terribly sensitive. I couldn't eat anything. Every fruit would give me pain. Every cold dish would pain. Absolute suffering all the way through. Through the carnivore diet, naturally you stay away from carby, starchy, sugary foods. You give your teeth for the first time the chance to recover, the chance to remineralize. Finally, you can truly open up that D3, K2, calcium pathways, and you can induce total regeneration. My teeth are not sensitive at all anymore. They feel strong. I do not have any pain whilst eating. This must be among the biggest benefits. Benefit number 7, inflammation. This is a big one as well. As a vegan, I injured myself quite frequently. ACL torn apart. Same goes for the biceps. My hamstring ripped apart as well. Constant dehydration and frailness, weakness, would always lead to injuries. With that came a lot of inflammation, of course. Unfortunately, those injuries didn't heal. I suffered from those injuries for at least half a year before I started reintroducing the animal foods again. They helped tremendously, but the pain was still there. My body started healing, but not as efficient as with the carnivore diet. On the carnivore diet, guys, I know it sounds like a sales pitch almost, but the inflammation was gone in the time of 3 days. After 3 days, there was no inflammation in my body. My knees felt rejuvenated. My biceps finally started healing. It was an amazing feeling. As I said, total regeneration. Benefit number 8, and this is the last benefit that I can think of, zero dry skin. Finally, the vegan dry skin issues are gone. Again, as I said, with the reintroduction of animal foods, my skin got moisturized quite a bit, but nothing in comparison to the carnivore diet. Maybe it is due to the higher fat intake. Maybe it is due to the higher collagen intake. Either way, finally, I do not experience any dry skin, especially dry hands. All of that is in the past now. But before you blame me to be a shill, to be a carnivore salesman, let's talk about the cons. Let's talk about the downsides. Alright, downside number 1 on the carnivore diet. The portion size of the food was sometimes a little bit too small. If I could eat a salad, if I could tolerate a salad, believe it or not, I would add it to my meal. I would prefer it. Why would I lie? But unfortunately, every time I eat a salad, I get diarrhea. It is absolutely indigestible for me. That was a small downside to the carnivore diet. Again, you can always eat a little bit more. You can add a little bit of butter, a little bit of salmon roe, something on those lines to add a little bit more quantity to your meals. But to be totally honest and transparent, if I could add some veggies for quantity, I would have done so. Downside number 2, body odor. Yes, I hear the vegans screaming already, keto crotch is real. It wasn't so much the keto crotch, but much more the armpits. Depending on the food sourcing and the food combining, I would definitely experience a little bit more of an acidic smell. Not gonna lie about it. It wasn't there all the way through. Nowadays, it is non-existent. But especially in the beginning, in the adaptation phase, I would feel an increased smell, an increased body odor. And that was definitely a downside of the carnivore diet. Downside number three, this one is crucial, and this one is why I ended the carnivore experiment. It was the inability to make real bodybuilding gains. Yes, unfortunately. Let's be honest, guys. The sport of bodybuilding has existed for at least 120 years. Those guys know how it works. Those guys know how to make gains. If you're really focused on bodybuilding gains, if you want to have perfect mass gains, you will have to follow those bodybuilding principles, those old school bodybuilding principles. And you always will need carbohydrates. It just makes it so much easier. If I learned anything through veganism, it is about the importance of preformed nutrients. Let's be honest, you look into the vegan dogma, the vegan camp, they will tell you, you do not need creatine because you can form it yourself, right? There's so many non-essential amino acids, so many non-essential fatty acids, and you can build them all yourself. Now as carnivores, we rely on gluconeogenesis, right? We rely on the conversion of proteins into carbohydrates to achieve perfect gains. But that is of course not needed. We can choose a simple approach, a more simplified version of the carnivore diet. And we can simply add a little bit of honey, maybe a couple of fruits into the mix, or like old school bodybuilders always did, a little bit of rice if you digest it well. For bodybuilding gains, this will always be the go-to method. Have some lean protein sources, moderate amounts of fats, and moderate amounts of carbohydrates. Like this, you always have full glycogen stores that will lead to tremendous pumps and tremendous gains. All right, those were the pros and the cons. Now we're gonna talk about the carnivore aftermath, and we're gonna talk about certain aspects that are worth mentioning. So guys, through the whole carnivore experiment, I have to tell you that the social aspect wasn't hard at all. As a vegan, it is much, much harder to go out to a restaurant. Yeah, of course, you can always eat side dishes if you want to compromise your health. But let's be honest, to have a fully balanced, wholesome meal as a vegan is not that easy. And on top of that, you will always get those weird questions from family members, friends, and whatnot. Not that I really care, but I just want to mention how easy it was to order a steak, especially during my time in France. I could easily eat some steak tartare, an omelette, some ground beef, an entrecote, and whatnot. It was absolutely easy for me. No problem whatsoever. Another thing that I want to mention is that during my 30 days on the zero carb carnivore experiment, I cheated once. I cheated once with a plant, with an avocado. Half an avocado. I just wanted to try it out to see how I will react. Maybe keto is the way to go. Maybe animal based is something that I should try. I had a weak moment. I tried it out, and let me tell you, it absolutely wrecked me. I felt like I ate a bunch of mushrooms. I was cowering in my room, belly cramps beyond belief. I almost had an outer body experience. Absolutely terrible. I haven't touched it since. Since the carnivore experiment, I experience fat adaptation. It is absolutely beautiful. As a vegan, I couldn't go without carbohydrates, not even for one meal. It was impossible. Fasting on the vegan diet was torture, absolute painful. Nowadays, I don't really mind. I can switch a carb meal for a fat meal. I can start my days with a banana and then have cevapcici as a second meal. I can switch my energy sources. Hey, maybe I want to eat some rice cakes, or maybe I just want to have a block of butter. Both works equally efficient, and that is the beauty of it. Even if you don't want to stay carnivore, if you give it a go, after that you will have that metabolic flexibility, and it's absolutely enjoyable to not rely on one single macronutrient. That is one more benefit on its own. Absolutely amazing. Since those days passed, I really have to say, guys, I miss the carnivore diet every single day. All the benefits that I just told you about, they are missing nowadays. The super flat belly, the absolute mental clarity, all of that is in the past now. I'm playing around with carbohydrates. And why is that so? Essentially, it is a trade-off for gains. Yes, I truly love bodybuilding. It is my crutch. I want to put on serious mass, and for that I need those carbohydrates. But it is a trade-off. You're basically trading your digestion for gains. That is what is truly happening. Since I reintroduced the carbohydrates, I'm playing around with polenta, with white rice, with sweet potatoes. Let me tell you, my digestion is improved. It's really not as if the carnivore diet further enhanced my digestive issues. Quite the opposite. I can get away with eating a burek or pizza even. I can have a cheat meal, especially nowadays here in Macedonia. But once you experience perfect digestion, and let me tell you, you can only achieve perfect digestion on a zero carb approach. Tell me about one vegan that is stuffing his face with lentils and has perfect digestion. If they tell you they have perfect digestion, they're clearly lying or they don't know any better. Try it out. Go on zero carbs, animal-based foods, and you will see there is zero bloating. How could there be? You have no fiber in your diet. It's absolutely perfect. Since then, as I said, I'm missing it every single day. I will return to the carnivore diet once I will get into cutting mode. It is a phenomenal way to reduce body fat. It is a phenomenal way to maintain. But as I said, for bodybuilding gains, it is not the way to go. Hence, I will always play around with carbohydrates for my performance goals. But I will always return to a fully carnivorous approach, 100%. Talking about bodybuilding, I have to mention here. Of course, the pump is not as good as it would be if you have carbohydrates in your diet. But let me tell you, the pump as a carnivore is still 10,000 times better than as a vegan. Even though I was eating high carb as a vegan, you just trash your insulin sensitivity. It doesn't matter how many carbohydrates you eat. Once you get fat adapted, you're super sensitive to carbohydrates. The pump is better than on a high carb vegan diet. Alright guys, and that sums it up. I hope you enjoyed the video. If so, leave it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed already, please do so. And as always guys, much love and peace.